Whoa, oh, whoa. Yeah, that's that sex in the bank. Tell her to open a safe. I hate a privileged rapper who don't even know what it takes. The diamonds ain't here like a... Oh, that's cause the neck is a prank.
Most of these things I wanna say. I wanna be around while you chase. You wanna hit me up when you make. You'll try to come back when you fake. I always want the truth, but it's dangerous. You got something real, not basic. You wanna get me started.
I was on this side, I was over on this side.
Hi dolls, and welcome in to another vlog. We are kicking off this week's vlog here in Houston. I'm so excited to be back in Houston. We're actually back this weekend for a concert for the Drake concert. You can see part of my little concert outfit back there, my cowboy hat. That's the only sneak peek you're getting right now, okay? But for those that don't know or that haven't followed me for a while, I used to live in Houston. I know you guys know I lived all over Texas for several years. One of those cities was Houston. Love my time here, like one of the best chapters of my life. So excited to be back and to be here to see like one of my favorite artists of all time. You guys know I love Drake. I have been captioning my Instagram posts with Drake lyrics since, I don't know, college, since I was like 17. So yes, I'm just wearing, this is just my airport fit. So I have the Drake tee that says Champagne Poppy. And then my Alexander Wang sweatpants, JBW watch, JBW bracelet. I lost my earrings in TSA, so we're gonna have to go to the Galleria to get some new ones. These are my concert nails. So I got some jewels this time, and they're like reflective silver. I'll show you better once we check into the hotel. And then just my YSL bag, and then same airport sneakers as always. I got them 2 years ago. From Pretty Little Thing. But yeah, so blessed to be back. I think I'm gonna try to find some Whataburger before checking into the hotel. That's it. Bye.
Thank you for choosing Whataburger. My name's Alondra. What can I get for you?
Can I get the number 13, the what a chicken strips?
What's the dippy sauce and drink?
Honey barbecue sauce and a lemonade. Oh. And then see. Thank you.
You have a good one, Mama.
You too.
Yo. I'm making a change today. The liquor been taking the pain away. I heard you was giving your chain away. That's kind of like giving your fame away. What's wrong with you? I sit in a box where the owners do. A boss is a road that I've grown into. I love you to death, but I told you the truth. I can't just be with you, I'm only you. Look, I got one girl, you got one, and that is the only two, man. How many times have I shown it, man? How many nights I've been, whoa, swerving the potholes? Not trying to fuck up the wheels on the road, okay? Funny how life goes. He thought he was sick, now we wiping his nose, okay? Soon as you give him your soul, you go up and they say you're selling your soul, okay? Then when my life exposed, they wanna know about the highs and lows. Well, summer, all I did was rest, okay? And New Year's, all I did was stretch, okay? I'm Valentine's Day, I had sex, okay? We'll see what's about to happen next, okay? Okay, okay, we'll see what's about to happen next. Today, the liquor been taking the pain away. I heard you was giving your chain away. That's kind of like giving your fame away. What's wrong with you? I sit in a box where the owners do. A boss is a road that I've grown into. I love you to death, but I told you the truth. Hey,
Yeah, I got one lawyer, got one in that day, the only two, man. How many times have I told you the truth, man? How many nights I've been woke, swerving them potholes? Not trying to fuck up the wheels or fuck up the deals. I'm posted in Stockholm. It's me, the owls, and the twins. It's only the real. I'm moving way too humble. Easier handed it off. I still got no fumbles. I'm on a hot 100, numero uno. This one ain't come with a bundle. I'm in no win, a million in chocolate chips. And that's your time, I could be crumbled. I put a skirt on a whip and a crown on a six, but there's no need to dress up the numbers. Hey, hey.
Hi, dolls. We are here in Houston checking in from my gorgeous hotel room here at the Post Oak Hotel in Houston. AKA the nicest, most bougie, luxury hotel in the city, in the state, and really like in much of the country. Dang, my curls look kind of good from that back mirror. Anyways, yes, we are here. I'm having a great time. Let me show you a tour of the room. Okay, I have stuff everywhere because I'm already running a little behind, but I'm gonna just show you guys like a quick tour, I guess. But first, yeah, let me straighten out the camera. Get into the robe, honey. Like, you know, a stay is not complete at the Post Oak if you're not posting in the robe, okay? Show a little angle, a little skin, a little toe. And then they it came with these slippers. And these are really big. Like, I think these are like boy slippers, but they just came in this. And normally I'd be like, I'm not wearing these, but they're really comfortable, actually. Okay, so for the tour, look at that. So, oh, not these like sounding so squeaky. Hold on, let me take these off. Anyways, so here's the front door, and then this messes with the lighting, so you can like, you know, set the mood, like whatever, you know, whatever you're trying to do, okay? And then, yeah, so you enter here, and then there's like this picture here, this little like entryway table, these two big beautiful doors, look at this detailing, that lead into the bathroom. And look at this pretty like chandelier light, I guess you could call it. And then, boom. Houston girls, let the wig us down. You a little Post Oak baby. You a little 48 baby. Anyways, this is the bathroom and it's gorgeous. So definitely we'll be taking a bubble bath in there. It has a TV so you can like put that on and relax. I just love like how neutral color and like cool tone everything is. And then this robe, there's two robes for two people, but this one was hanging up here and I just took it. And then they just have different like little toiletries and such as hotels do. And here's, what is this? Like soap and lotion or something. Yeah, shower gel, body lotion. And I love like how, you know, most hotels will give you that itty bitty little bottle of lotion and have you ashy. And so I like that they have this big bottle because I'm gonna need to use it. And a little mirror up there. And then there's another like chandelier light. First of all, look at the lighting in this mirror. Hold on, I've just been posing. This is why I'm late. Like, hello? Yeah, this light up here, chandelier light. Here is the shower. And I'm like, I don't know if I want to use the shower or the tub first. I really don't know. Here is the bath. Oh, and then they've got like a towels. A scale down there, and then a little tree for Post Oak. And then here's the bathroom. It's just a little toilet. I love like the little wall art canvases that they have. Actually, that is like similar to what I've been looking for my house. And so I'm taking like inspo from them because they're like has a similar vibe of what I'm going for wall art. And then they got a phone in the bathroom, like, I'm gonna call. I'm like, hello, I'm blowing it up, girl. Like, what? But maybe you just really like, maybe it is an emergency in there. I don't know. And then let me turn the camera around. Here is like the main room, but let me start with this because this is really cool. Of course, I'm keeping it hot because I'm always cold. So this is like your control panel and it controls everything. So you want all the lights off, you could do that. You want them all on, you could do that. If you want like entertainment lighting, you know, it's gonna set something. If you want romance lighting, get into it. Get into the romance lighting, okay? And then this is really cool too. So let me show you shears first. So you press shears and it automatically opens the shears. And look at this view. Hello. Stunning. Stunning. I mean, I'm backlit, but oh my gosh. Imagine like just having this lighting every day. Sick. So yeah, and then, oh, let me show you. Hold on. I'm trying to like, there's so many like cool gadgets in here. Okay, so then you can close the, where were we? The shears back. And then what you can also do, so you see they're closing now. And then you can also hit drapes and that will close like everything and make it like really dark and everything in here. But I don't want to like that right now, but I'm just showing you guys what you could do. Dang, come on. There we go. And then waiting for that light. Oh, I did turn the lights off. I was setting the romance. Okay. Here's the big, beautiful bed. Gorgeous. More wall art that I love. It has some chairs over here, a little like table, another couch, a table. Excuse my mess. I am eating and charging cameras and doing all kinds of stuff. And then one of my favorite parts of the room, this little like private bar section. So they have some selections for you here. Okay. And I will definitely be indulging. Here's their little menu, private bar menu. And I pulled out the yellow label, the champagne, because that's the one that I like. And then they have like little treats. I'm probably gonna eat these little gummy bears because I just don't have time. And this mug is so cute. It kind of matches my nails. Down there with some water. Then like here's some other alcohols that they had in here. I already pulled out the champagne that I wanted, so that's why that's empty. And then that's just an empty drawer down there. And look at their little like my Whataburger. That was my first stop from the airport. These little books, fashion books that they have here. Also, I think the TV is supposed to like rise up here. I haven't tried it yet, but let's see. I think that's what that cutout is for the TV. No? Oh, let's see. There's like buttons here. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Oh. Not the reflection. I could get used to this. Like, hello? Oh. See, I'm supposed to be out in the town, but part of me just wants to stay in here. Like, ah! Imagine watching TV like this. And this is the champagne that I'm going to be indulging in. As I get ready, I want to just have a glass. Well, I'm supposed to be saving it. Hold on. So I'm supposed to be saving some of it because I am having company, but I want it now. So I don't know. There was only one of that version in the wet bar or the private bar. So I also want to go downstairs and have a drink. They have like a couple different restaurants and bars in here, and like there's multiple different like social events happening right now. There's a wedding, there's like some business event, like it's popping. Like if you live in Houston or Texas, like this is not the weekend for you to stay inside at all. But I have reservations for dinner at Nobu tonight, and I don't think I've ever been to Nobu Houston, so I'm excited to see what that is like. And yeah, so I'm probably just gonna start getting ready and talk with you guys later. Bye. Okay, I'm getting ready to go to dinner at Nobu, waiting on my Uber. Here's the dress, and I'm running late.
She moved out of state, she doing left, she's seeking forgiveness. She used to dance, but she went home and started a business. Her daddy was not around, her mama was not around. I was just climbing the top of the pole, and they get started now. I make it rain in this bitch, I make it snow in this bitch. She trying to get out of her beats. Shawty was born legit, Shawty was born legit. Me, I'm supporting this shit. This is a story that came from my life, and I'm supporting this shit. I'ma just give it to you the way instead of me pulling this shit. You know you're important and shit. You know I'm supporting this shit. We used to do pornos when you would come over, and now you got morals and shit. I got a phone on the wrist and an adorable kid. I got a Drake in the studio, and I don't just mean that I'm in this bitch. Please make the most of this shit. Don't just come close to some shit. I give you this bread, you brought me some head, and ain't no blood with me. She moved out of state, she did my left, she's seeking forgiveness. She used to dance, but she went alone and started a business. Daddy was not around, my mama was not around. I watch her climb up the top of the pole and niggas. I make it great in this bitch, I make it slow in this bitch. She trying to get out of the mix. Shawty was going legit, Shawty was going legit. He up supporting this shit. This is a story you came from the life of supporting this shit. Daddy was not around, my mama was definitely not around. She got a business plan, but she just ain't had time. Stay with the sister now, she got a man, but he's out of town. As soon as he's out of town, they hop in his whip and they ride around.
I wanted to show you guys another way to control all the cool features in the room. It's this tablet that has a bunch of different like prompts and menus on it. So for example, it's all dark in here right now. We want to change that though, so let's open the drapes and the shears. Good morning.
For me, this is something I know, I know, I know. So tonight I'll just make you like we're in Houston. Taking everything slow, so slow, so slow.
Okay. Hey you guys. I don't think I tied this dress right. I just wanted to show you what I'm wearing today. It's this little cute dress. I don't remember who it's by, but I'll find it and I'll put the text up. I know I didn't tie this right because, hello? We're gonna have to move real careful in this one. Oh, also I have my little Whataburger over here. I'm like, should I like put a drink in here? here and take it to the pool, but I'm like, girl, you could just order a drink at the pool. Be so freaking thrilled. So, good morning. It is Drake weekend. Woo, I'm so excited. I'm going to go to the pool to try out. Why aren't you looking at my face? Okay, there. So this is the pool fit. I want to go to the pool for breakfast and like a cocktail, and I just have my Dior slides on, JBW watch, and my JBW bracelet. If it will focus. Yeah, for a quick bite, a drink, and then I need to figure out like what my strategy is going to be, because since I have floor tickets for Drake, we're supposed to like get in line to get a wristband, and then they're opening up the concession early to like get your merch and stuff. And so ideally I would like to go get my wristband, get my merch, because I want a t-shirt or two, come back to the hotel, go to the bar, go to dinner, go back for the concert. But I just know I'm not going to be able to like do it like that, so I have to figure out the math, the girl math. But yeah, much more energy today, well rested or whatever. And yeah, I'll check in with you guys later. Bye. Oh, I also forgot to show you guys, I'm gonna just take my YSL bag down there, and then for scent this weekend, cause I'm real like late night with it, you know? Even though it's daytime, I'm wearing a spray. This is YSL Libre, my signature scent. And then a roll, so this is a spray. And then the roller ball of Good Girl, like this. You see that? So I'm just layering those two this weekend. They smell so bomb, and they smell luxury, and like what I feel like you should be wearing if you're staying at the Post Oak Hotel in Houston, okay? And then I just go in with a roller ball and like some of my hot points. And yeah. Okay, checking with you guys later. Bye.
Feeling young, but they treat me like the OG. And they want the tea on me, I swear these bitches nosy. Said he put some money on my head, I guess we gon' see. I won't put no money on this head, my niggas owe me. I gotta be single for a while, you can't control me. On no those traits in a race, they can't hold me. And I show my face in a case, so you know it's me. Imitation isn't flattery, it's just annoying me. And I'm told about it. And the dirt that they do on my name turns full, and I do about it. Time for y'all to figure out what y'all gonna do about it. Big wheels keep rolling, rolling. Outside, 29, G5.
Hey you guys, so we're here poolside at the Post Oak Hotel now. I'm just looking over their menu to decide on a drink and something to eat for breakfast. And then they gave me a water to serve and some sunscreen. Oh, my waiter's coming, so I'll check in with you guys later. Bye. Okay, guys, so my drink just came. I ordered a glass of champagne and a like turkey club sandwich. I don't know, the waiter said that it's like his favorite sandwich here. And I'm a picky eater, so that's what I got. So here's this. Oh, let me show you. It's like it has a pink hue to it. Oh, cheers. Sandwich is bomb. The best turkey club I probably ever had. Something about like the sauce and the crunch.
I've been losing friends and finding peace. But honestly, that sound like a fair trade to me. If I ever heard one and I'm still here outside, front line, south side. I've been losing friends and finding peace. Honestly, that sound like a fair trade to me. Look, I'm in Miami, over here, I'm throwing another pity party. Looking back, it's hard to tell you where I started. I don't know who loved me, but I know that it ain't everybody.
Okay, you guys, I'm here outside of the Toyota Center to get my merch early for the Drake concert. You can see that's the official merchandise tent. They started selling at 4. I got here like 4:20, and I was like in and out in like less than 5 minutes. Here's all my merch. I got 2 shirts and a hoodie, and the total is like $220, something like that. I'll show you when I get back to the hotel. And then way back there where you see that line of people, that's the line for the floor wristbands. They're doing it different here than in other cities. In other cities, you could get in your line, get your wristband early, and then go get ready and come back. Here, I just found out that they're not giving you your wristband until 6:30 and doors open at 7. So I was trying to get my wristband early so I can get an earlier number in line, get ready to come back, you know? But now I just have to go get ready and come back and be in line at whatever point I am. Right now the line is not that bad. I'd say there's probably like less than 100. Is this my Uber? No. I'd say there's like less than 100 people in line right now, but it's only a little after 4, like not even 4:30 p.m. So that could change. I just showered really quick, came to get my merch. I want to go to Target because I need a new poster board. I don't know if I have time. I'm going back to the hotel now to get ready, and they have a car service and a delivery service, so I might have somebody else get it and bring it to the room. Yeah. A few hours away. Okay, bye. Yes, to the poster, please. Damn, where I get it from? These niggas always wonder who. Then they meet my pop and tell them Drake is just the younger you and shout it on a poster board in my suitcase to get through TSA. So, and I knew this would happen. I came to the closest Target to my hotel at the Post Oak. They were sold out of all the regular poster boards because obviously everyone got them for the concert. But I got like little canvases that will work and they're the proper size. And then I got one big one that I can cut in case of emergency. So now I'm just waiting for the house car. They said they were on their way. But yeah, and then finally, we'll get ready for this day in concert. Okay, bye. Hello. Okay, time to get ready for the Drake concert. I'm scared.
May you fall, hide before the idea in my head. Say rare, he ain't sign, that ain't a good sign. Change your mind, good conversation, that's on rosy wine. There's still some other things you got in mind.
Come on now. Hey. It's my microphone.
Hey. It's smoking me talking in Dutch. I couldn't be beating so wet. She leaning on me, I'm a crutch. She creeping on me, I'm a clutch. The photos don't need a retouch. She asked what I'm having a nut. I didn't know we're in a rush. Enjoying the moment so much.
Shut up.
I was paying the bills. I don't even need a deluxe. My stomach is fat as fuck. She stuffing that shit in the bus. I'm probably fat myself in the bus. I don't even ask her to see. She's saying that shit is natural. I don't care if you're making it up. I know cause you an old girl. I'm always gonna see your truck.
I'm always gonna keep it up.
You give me this shit and I'll stay on my way.
Oh my god, you guys, I'm so late. I stopped to take my Instagram pictures, but like I wanted to show you the fit. Like, get into the fit. So this is custom Drake corset. This skirt is from, it's a little short girl. It's from, dang, Revolve maybe? No. Jaded London. Boots from Amazon. This hat is from Boohoo. And then my jewelry, I have a little owl OVO necklace. And then some rings. The necklace and rings are from Amazon. My JBW watch, my JBW bracelet, and then I put some like sparkles. I don't know if you could see, just like, you know, stepping it up. This hat is so fun. Listen, yeah, your girl is behind, but I feel really cute. I have another pair of cowboy boots, so my feet don't hurt. They're also the same color and have memory foam. I don't know if I'm gonna have time to put them on, so I might just have to wear like my bad B boots that I have on right now. Yes, I feel like this is very Houston. Houston girls look like Houston. Okay, when I come back before I go to the club tonight, I will try to like get some more looks for you guys. But I'm out of time, like, they've already opened the doors. Okay. My moral compass is janky and breaks in the south. Hey!
Kept the gallery open till 10 for you and your friends. You know how I spend in H-O-U-S-T-O-N. I get too crazy, had a little bad enough. We stay good friends, we get too wavy. All I know is that when this cup ends, the next one begins. You know I'm making my way to your ends. And you know I need you to be there for me. You a little Poso baby, you a little 48 baby. Got a little candy in her pocket, she gon' take off like a. You already know, no. I'm
do it. You too, bye. Okay. So, looks like we can order from any of the restaurants.
Wait.
Looks like we can order from any of the restaurants poolside for breakfast and drink. So I'm gonna get ready. Yeah, we'll do pool, have some food, have like a mimosa or something. And then I just have a lot of things to do. Okay. Here's the water they give you. A little mist. And oops, it's stuck on the neck. Little cup. Was amazing. I'm trying to get my voice back. I don't even want to smell alcohol. I don't know why I drank that. I'm going to talk more about the concert in a little bit, but I guess I should first explain a little bit more about like Houston and why this is so significant for me. I don't know if you guys can see me. Maybe should I take these glasses off? I think they have a glare. Yeah, so like I was saying, I moved to Texas when I was like 19, 20 years old. Amazing chapter of my life. I love, love, love Texas. Like, that was like peak prime Imani. Had a blast. Great chapter. I moved here for a news internship when I was in college. And I was going to school in Arizona at the time, but I won this like super coveted, super competitive internship. They had so many applicants. They chose like four or five of us across the entire country. And they were like, okay, congratulations, now we need you to pack up and move out here for a few months to do your internship. And at the time, I wasn't really thinking about it. I didn't think I was gonna get it. And, you know, I was a broke college kid on the West Coast, clear across the country. And while I was making good money in my college job for a college kid, it wasn't adult money. And it definitely wasn't enough money to pick up my life and move across the country to Houston, Texas. So, if you didn't know, Houston's very diverse and they have a large like immigrant community and like just people moving here from different places, different countries, etc. And I wanted the internship. I didn't know how I was going to afford to move out here or pay rent. And I joined this like Facebook group of like people who were moving from other countries. And I found this girl. She was from China, I think. She didn't speak like a lick of English. And she rented me for like $200 a month her... Well, she told me it was like a separate room in her apartment. When I got there, I found out it was just like her living room floor. And she put up like a sheet, a bed, like a, not even this nice, not even this thick, like a thin sheet to separate like the living room from the rest of the house. It was a one bedroom apartment. And I slept on the floor. I came with an air mattress and literally like a Walmart bag of clothes. She let me sleep on her floor, $200 a month. It was in the absolute hood, like a super dangerous hood part of Houston. And I was so scared. My first, you know, I was coming from a pretty privileged life on the West Coast. Had never been to Houston before. And I was scared. I you know, the first night sleeping there, I was just hearing so much activity, so much was going on. I was like, am I going to get trafficked? Are we going to get robbed? Is somebody going to get shot? And a lot of those things did happen in that complex. Thankfully, you know, nothing to me or the girl. And in the internship, I made just enough money to pay her rent and like to cover my Uber to and from the news station, because the news station wasn't too far away, and like a little bit of food. And I had an incredible time. I worked really hard in that internship, pulling doubles, doing a lot, and that really helped me launch my news career. And so it's emotional for me to be back here in Houston, because I just think about, like, when I lived here and I was broke, sleeping on a stranger's floor on an air mattress, and people thought I was crazy, and they didn't see the vision, and they said I should have just stayed on the West Coast where I was comfortable, but I just believed in myself, and I knew it would pay off. And so now, you know, all these years later, to be able to come back to Houston with a lot more money, and to stay in the Post Oak, paid with my own money, the nicest five-star hotel in the city, in the state, in most of the country, and to have this incredible experience because I chose to bet on myself and believe in myself is an overwhelming feeling. And I think if 19-year-old Imani, who was sleeping on that girl's floor, could see Imani today sleeping in the Post Oak because she decided to follow her dreams, I think she'd be in awe, amazed, and very proud. So I guess I just say that to say, if you're going through like a hard time, or you're trying to follow your dreams and you don't feel like supported, or like it's, you know, it's not making sense right now, just like, don't give up. As long as you like work hard, you believe in yourself, like, and you're consistent, then you can do it. So that's, oh, I don't want to get emotional. So that's why, Houston is very special to me. It really helped me launch my career, which has afforded me the opportunity to be able to come back in, you know, a much better position. But I'm thankful for my time in that girl's house, and just, you know, it really made me toughen my skin and grow. So anyways, but yes, it was in the hood. I hope I have time to drive by today before I head to the airport. I don't think I'll have time. Maybe I'll have to come back and do that another time, but it's very special to me. And funny enough, one of the guys, when I first moved here to Houston, one of the guys I was dating played for the Texans. And it's so funny. He told me like later, not like when we first started dating, but I would have him come pick me up at the girl's place. And he, you know, drove a very nice car, like very recognizable. And that was the like summer or the time when like Plenty of Fish was popular, but it was popular for crime reasons. Like guys would pretend to be girls on there and invite guys over and like rob them or whatever. And I remember he'd come pick me up and he would be so nervous. And he'd tell me like, oh, I'll send you a car to come to me, like my side of town, or, you know, an Uber, or like, I'll pick you up down the street. And, you know, 19-year-old Imani, I'm like, like, you need to put in the effort. You need to come to the door and get me. You need to scoop me, like, right outside, like, da-da-da-da. And later on, like, after we had been dating for a while, he told me, like, he was scared. Like, he was like, that apartment was, like, so bad. He was telling me he thought, like, I was trying to set him up. Like, somebody was going to, like, come out of the apartment and try to rob him or take his car. And, like, looking back, I'm like, that absolutely could have happened. Like, they could have done that. They could have broke your kneecaps. Like, you should not have been over there. But it was funny. It was fun. Anyways, so that's that. I need to stop drinking that. I'm gonna try to go to the pool, and then I gotta pack, and then we gotta hit the road. Okay.
On my head, I guess we gon' see. I won't put no money on this shit. My niggas owe me. I gotta be single for a while. You can't control me. On no those traits in a race, they can't hold me. And I show my face in a case, so you know it's me. Imitation isn't flattery, it's just annoying me. And I'm told about it. And the dirt that they do on my name turns soil, and I do about it. Time for y'all to figure out what y'all gon' do about it. Big wheels keep rolling, rolling outside. 29, G5, Seaside. I've been losing friends and finding peace. But honestly, that sound like a fair trade to me. If I ever heard one, and I'm still here outside. Frontline, Southside. I've been losing friends.
doesn't find a peace. Honestly, that sound like a fair trade to me. Look, don't invite me over if I'm throwing another pity party. Looking back, it's hard to tell you where I started. I don't know who loved me, but I know that it ain't everybody. I can never love to see a busybody. Baby, if you want me, can we turn it up with everybody? Nah, can't be fucking on this anybody. Yeah, I got feelings for you, that's the thing about it. Yeah, you know that it's something when I sing about it. Yeah, mama used to be on disability, but gave me disability. And now she walking with her hand high and her back straight. I don't think you're feeling me, I'm out here. Being everything they said I wouldn't be, a couldn't be. I don't know what happened to them guys that said they would be. I said, see you at the top and they misunderstood me. I don't know this damage in my heart, this damn maturity. And we don't keep it on us anymore, it's with security. I'm outside, 29, G5, Seaside. I've been losing friends and finding peace. But honestly, that sound like a fair straight to me. If I ever
Hey guys, so I am now back home, a little sad about it, but I'm back home from Houston, from the Drake concert, and just got home from work, and I'm still so tired. I don't know, you probably can't tell, but like I've been scrubbing my face and I still cannot get all the glitter off of me. I just like got the wristband off of me, like your girl's going through it. But I just wanted to come in here really quickly and recap the concert. First of all, this is a brand new phone. I bought brand spanking new for the Drake concert specifically, so I can have extra space for photos and videos. I also bought like a portable charger just for the concert, just for my phone to still die during the concert. But I can't blame anyone but myself, because if you follow me on TikTok, you saw like what I was doing while I was getting ready. Like, I was just taking so long, and when I was rushing, I grabbed the cord for my vlog camera instead of this, and didn't realize it till I was standing in the floor where like I couldn't go anywhere and my phone was on 20%. I was sick about it, but still had a really great time. Somehow, even though my phone was on 20%, I was still able to record like most of the concert. I got most of Drake. But unfortunately, I only got like one song by 21 Savage, which sucked, because like they played Hours in Silence later, and like his surprise songs for Houston were In Too Deep and November 18th, which I have been playing on my Instagram stories all weekend. So I couldn't record any of that. And then 21 Savage and I had a little moment, like we sang to each other for like half a song. He liked my cowboy hat, and I wasn't able to record any of that, but it's fine because I still got so many great videos and had an amazing, amazing time. Now, let me just get into a few things. I have floor seats. Now, could I have gotten there earlier and like, sure, but I was late getting ready, and I got there like 2 hours after the concert started, like literally 30 minutes before Drake came out. Somehow I was still able to make it front row, which is like, but to have floor seats is a lot. I'm not too upset that I wasn't able to record the end of the concert, solely because I was dying by the end of the concert. Like, by the time they got around to Hours in Silence and some of the other songs that they were playing at the end, I wasn't even singing along because I literally felt like I was gonna pass out. We have been packed together like sardines for hours. They were pulling girls out of the crowd because they were like about to pass out. It was hot. We had no space. Like, we had no water. Like, literally. And I went so hard in the beginning because I was so excited. The last like couple songs, like the last like 4 or 5 songs, like I was just trying to survive. Just trying to survive. So just keep that in mind if you're doing floor. The other thing that really got me tight is the men at the concert. Now, this isn't to all the men. To the men who are just there to genuinely enjoy the concert, this does not apply to you. This is strictly for the men that were doing too much. You would not believe the amount of men at the concert that were pushing and elbowing girls out the way, trying to do that to myself included, trying to get front row, to like touch Drake, to be close to Drake, 21 Savage, da-da-da, whatever. And I'm like, let's be very clear, like, Drake wants to see the baddies front row. Like, he's not want to see all y'all men. I'm like, what are you doing? And the thing that makes me mad about it is, like, one, like, don't put your hands on a girl, first of all. But secondly, like, we're small. Like, I'm 5'5". A lot of the other girls front row were even smaller than me. And these men were, like, 6 foot plus, like, towering over us. So, like, you can stand behind us and still get a good view, get good video, make eye contact, whatever your goal was. So to, like, try to push us girls out the way, crazy. And what are you, like, you're a man, like, what are you even, like, doing here? Like, to be honest. Anyway, so that got me, like, annoyed, but it could have been worse. And then the last thing that I just thought was funny, like, I've always thought of myself as a pretty big Drake fan, but some of the fans at the concert show me, like, oh, I'm just, like, for play. Because I'm like, oh, I like Drake because, you know, his songs make me, like, feel like that girl. You know, like, I grew up listening to him. His music's relatable to a lot of, like, my life situations about, like, heartbreak and relationships and success and rising in your career, betrayal and, like, growth and a lot of different things. And they make great Instagram captions, his lyrics. So I thought that was the type of time we all were on. So Drake comes to the front and, you know, I'm front row. So I'm like, ooh, like, I got my sign. I'm like, ooh, like, Drake, whatever. The girl next to me, she starts screaming for Drake too. And she goes, ooh, Drake, I have you, like, tattooed 3 times on my body. Come sign my tattoos of you on my body. I said, oh, like, you just gonna have to outdo me then, baby girl. Because, like, I am not, like, doing all of that. And I looked over at her. She did have multiple tattoos of Drake on her body. And I said, oh, okay. you know, I thought, you know, I was just here for, like, the Instagram captions, apparently. I don't really know. So that was just funny, like, seeing the different levels. And then you guys know he gives out, like, designer bags at his show, like Birkins or Chanel's. And I, like, wrote out a sign. I had a funny, like, cheeky message on one side and, like, an inspirational message, like, how his music helped me on the other. And I'm like, oh, you know, I've got the 2 different messages. I'll keep flipping them. I'm front row. Like, I'll get the bag. But this other girl, she was front row, like, around the corner, and she had a sign. And it, like, said, basically she owned, like, a salon or spa or something. And she said, I had to wax 50 to, like, be able to afford a ticket to come to this concert. Or she had to wax 50 girls who were coming to the concert or something like that. And Drake was like, that's so creative. Like, I've never seen a sign like that in my life. Da-da-da. So he gave her the Chanel. And I'm sick because it was actually one of the Chanel bags I've been eyeing. So that's a tip. Like, just make sure you have, like, a sign that stands out, not something like a basic like I had. But yeah, other than that, super amazing show. He played a lot of great songs, like, kept people energized, like, had, like, different cool effects. Who was there? Central C, French Montana, Johnny Manziel. Second night in Houston, he had, like, Travis Scott. I think Lil Yachty was in the building. Honestly, like, by the time I started to, like, pass out, I was disassociating. So I don't really know, but it was amazing. And I think I might go to his final show in Toronto as well. So, yeah. Oh, and I want to show you guys my merch. Hold on. Okay, I think I mentioned this when I was, like, at the merch shop. I don't remember, but I paid, like, I think it was, like, $220 for 3 items, 2 t-shirts and a sweatshirt. So the first shirt I got, which I've already worn, is this one here, which I think is from the Dark Lane demo tapes little album or whatever he put out. This cover, I'm pretty sure that's where it's from. And then on the back, it just says the letters spell out, like, It's All a Blur for the It's All a Blur tour, and then it says 2023. This is my favorite one. This is the one I wanted real bad, real cute. The second shirt I got is this one, which I thought this was the front. It's actually the back. So the front is this little symbol from his new upcoming album, For All the Dogs, which is going to be released in October, and it's sounding like old Drake already, so I'm really excited about it. And then this is the back. It says For All the Dogs, but knowing me, I'm probably going to wear it this way because this is why I bought it. It was, like, real cute. And then his son, I don't know if you guys know this, his son, this is the album cover, and his son, like, designed this, or drew it, whatever. And then the last thing I got was this sweatshirt, or this hoodie. This is what it looks like on the front, just this little logo. And then on the back, it says 21 Savage, It's All a Blur Tour 2023, and then it's got all the cities that the tour is in. So yeah, that's it. Overall, great time, great memories. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you know I was like posting up a storm. Like when I'm in Houston, I'm in peak form. Okay, like I'm in my prime. And I was posting up a storm, so post on Instagram, make sure you like those pictures. And yeah, I had a great time at the Post Oak. Met a lot of great girls. And my favorite thing is like meeting other girls that are just like beautiful and like confident and secure in themselves and like supportive and positive and like want to have a good time. I'm like, I love that. So met a lot of wonderful girls like that. And yeah, just really like had a great time. I'm already trying to plan my next trip back to Houston. And everybody was hitting me up like, oh, I see you in my city. I'm like, yes, I'm in your city. Got myself into a little trouble. Anyways, I'm rambling now. I really don't have anything else to talk about. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I wanted to tell you guys about Houston. No, got my Whataburger, which was really good. Yeah. So I think this is where I'm going to end this vlog because I'm so exhausted. My hair is so crunchy. I'm getting it done this weekend. And yeah. It all really was a blur. See what I did there? Okay, well, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next vlog. Bye. She got a man, but he out of time. As soon as he out of time, they hop in his whip and they ride.